A brief excerpt from the subtype program of people born on May 10th of leap years or May 11th of common years. Information is presented using women as an example and is selectively taken from the catalog of human population.
In an intellectual sphere, this person is always concerned about something, all sort of strangely mixed up, all in a continuous fluster, all trembling, anxious, and worried about others, herself, and anything and everything. This individual never feels calm, safe, and considers actions of people at constant attacks, accusations, aggressive pretensions. This person feels like a scapegoat, a target for ridicule, and that all people who simply feel like it maltreat this person due to his or her feminine weakness. It seems to this person that he or she is always the one at fault. Every person tries to offend, to humiliate him or her, and therefore this individual is always playing the role of our poor miserable. Although this person loves and knows how to offend, mock, and especially tease, rather, this individual provokes all above mentioned actions of others that are directed at him or her. First of all, this gets done in order to complain plenty after and say, "Here we go again, I'm being blamed," and to accuse everyone around that they are offending him or her, and are not only tying this person to the house, family and children, but also are making a laughing stock out of him or her. This person does this out of love to prevent himself or herself as an unskilled, awkward person who acts irrelevantly, constantly makes mistakes, etc. This individual often considers herself, himself, a blowball. Blow on it and it will disperse. She or he regularly demonstrates helplessness, defenselessness, inaptitude, and keeps saying that he or she feels in danger, that the world is so cruel. Actually, such behavior is used to show others, and first of all to show the significant other that she or he needs support, guarding, protection, and of course, financial support. And in the end, under the slogan, "Let's do everything all together as a family," to get the other half to actually work for him or her, especially while children are small. This person thinks that his or her other half is simply obligated not only to participate in the joint nurturing and upbringing, but also to create the most favorable material conditions for the family. Anxiety and bustling are also connected with a huge number of things to do, which this individual arranges himself or herself. Life of this individual can be compared to a crossword puzzle in a newspaper, which contains an unthinkable number of words. But instead of words, this person has things to do, and this crossword puzzle has no end. A characteristic trait of this individual is that he or she always finds a huge pile of things to do, concerns, and problems, from which he or she literally bursts at the seams. On the other side, in some sense, this individual is very similar to an ordinary looking small gray sparrow, which constantly rushes about and fusses. While flying from one place to another, picks a worm here, a grain there, and flies on. This person is like a sparrow. From morning until night, he or she travels short duration and distance wise, absorbed in affairs and concerns, and does all this with a fuss, faster and faster, jumps from one thing to another. An early bird gets to God's hand, he or she thinks, and that is why from early morning this person is on his or her feet, and it all begins. He or she fusses and bustles about, runs around, appears here and there, makes phone calls, wipes one child's nose, puts something into another child's mouth, stirs something that is cooking on the stove during the breaks, irons at the last moment just before it's time to leave. An observer might get dizzy from this fussing around. And in the end, this person says, "Oh, I don't have enough time to drink coffee," or, "Oops, somehow forgot to wash my face." This happens because this individual likes to complain, to whine, that he or she is locked at home. All the housework falls on him or her. In addition, everything is bad. Everything hurts. It is a nightmare. This person, this through the eyes. He or she sees something and then flies there with all might. The bustling of this person also consists in that it is necessary for him or her to get away somewhere constantly. However, this must be nearby, short distance from home, to rush to the other end, and not only the world, but even town or neighborhood in which he or she lives, to travel, to fly, to sail somewhere far. All this is uncomfortable for this individual. Going to the other side of town or traveling to another country, these actions are equally problematic for this person. All long-distance flights are not for him or her. Therefore, this individual does not travel for prolonged periods of time or far from the nest, the home where the favorite nestlings are. However, love and attachment of this person to the nest do not lead to cleanliness and order in the house. There is trash everywhere. Things are scattered all over the place. It feels like he or she just about to clean everything up, but something interrupted process. Actually, for this individual, the state of it is necessary to clean up never ends, or rather, it never becomes a real action. This person is not a very good homemaker and is unable to not only clean up, but even to prepare a delicious meal.